Child Psychology, written by the Center of Excellence, narrated by Brian Greyson. Welcome to the Center of Excellence Child Psychology audio course. Child psychology is the branch of psychology that studies the social and mental development of children. Understanding how children develop can aid in the understanding of how to raise well-balanced, productive individuals, as well as provide some universal insights into human nature. Jean Piaget, a Swiss developmental psychologist and philosopher, known for his epistemological studies with children, suggested that children actually think differently than adults. Before Piaget's work, the common assumption in psychology was that children are merely less competent thinkers than adults. According to Piaget, children are born with a very basic mental structure, genetically inherited and evolved, on which all subsequent learning and knowledge is based. Today, psychologists recognise that child psychology is unique and complex, but many differ in terms of the unique perspective they take when approaching development. This course on psychological development of children looks at the development of very young children. It deals with topics such as the development of perception, knowledge, skills and relationships, the way in which biological, social and cultural influences interact in a child's development is a central theme examined from different points of view in modern psychological research and theory. This book introduces the main theoretical approaches to child development that are explored further throughout the course. In this course, we shall cover some of the major concepts in child psychology. The course is divided into two modules. The first module deals with the physical, social, and behavioural development of the child and the influence that family, friends, and the environment as a whole plays in their overall development. The second module deals with understanding the child as an individual. In this, we shall study various aspects such as moral development, development of gender roles, aggression in children, and behaviour modification. Child Psychology, Unit 1, Child Developments in the First 12 Months. Neonate is the term used to refer to the newborn baby in the first month of life. When the child is born, he has to adjust to an environment which is very different from the one in the mother's womb. From this comfortable existence, the baby is pushed out into an atmosphere of relative discomfort. He may be surrounded by air which may be cold or hot, dry or humid. He has to cry to indicate that he is hungry, wet or uncomfortable. Thus we can infer that the newborn has many capabilities which help him to adjust to new surroundings. The first year of life is one of the most critical stages in childhood development. From the moment they open their eyes, newborns undergo dramatic physical and mental changes. It can be said that this critical period of a child's development offers great opportunities for each child, but it is also the period when those opportunities can be wasted. Poor upbringing in the first years of life is later reflected in feelings of dissatisfaction with life, impaired relationships, learning difficulties, eating disorders, high rates of crime and violence, addiction and other personal and social issues. It is evident that such disorders become increasingly more expensive and difficult to treat later in life, often bringing no results. Although each child develops at his or her own pace, numerous studies show that the development is fastest during the period before the age of 3. During that time, and especially during the first year of life, small children usually live in the privacy of their homes and are completely dependent upon adults. Thus, parenting skills are crucial in bringing up children, providing emotional support, encouraging their development, and establishing successful communication with them. Dr. Ronnie Liederman, Associate Dean at the Mailman Siegel Institute for Early Childhood Studies at Nova Southeastern University in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, explains that a newborn's brain has the potential to produce billions of cells and neurons. These cells and the connections that are made between cells form the basis for a child to function in the world. Between conception and age 3, a child's brain undergoes an impressive amount of change. At birth, it already has about all of the neurons it will ever have. It doubles in size in the first year and by age 3 it has reached 80% of its adult volume. In Table 1.1, it shows that the brain development, especially related to vision, hearing, language and cognitive functions, is extremely fast in the early years of life, especially the first year. The brain continues to develop at an amazing rate throughout the first year. The cerebellum triples in size, which appears to be related to the rapid development of motor skills that occurs during this period. As the visual areas of the cortex grow, the infant's initially dim and limited sight develops into full binocular vision. Brain research has shown that nurturing in the earliest years is crucial for emotional and social as well as intellectual development. In particular, children develop their sense of trust and attachment very early in life, as well as begin to develop their cognitive and pre-literacy skills. We'll now look at infant reflexes. A reflex is a muscle reaction type of stimulant that happens automatically in response to certain types of stimulation. Certain sensations or movements produce specific muscle responses. The presence and strength of a reflex is an important sign. Neonatal reflexes are inborn reflexes which are present at birth and occur in a predictable fashion. A normally developing newborn should respond to certain stimuli with these reflexes, which eventually become inhibited as the child matures of nervous system development and function. Many infant reflexes disappear as the child grows older, although some remain throughout adulthood. Infant reflexes are reflexes that are normal in infants but abnormal in other age groups. Such reflexes include the Morrow reflex. It is stimulated if the infant's head suddenly shifts position, the temperature changes abruptly, or by sudden movement or loud noise. A normally developing neonate will respond by throwing the arms and legs out with the palms up and thumbs flexed, and then pulling them towards the body. The Sucking reflex. If the roof of your baby's mouth is touched with a finger, a pacifier, or a nipple, he will instinctively begin sucking. It is common to all mammals and is present at birth. It is linked with the rooting reflex and breastfeeding. The rooting reflex. Rooting reflex occurs when you stroke the baby's cheek. The infant will turn towards the side that was stroked and begin to make sucking motions with the mouth. The step reflex. When the soles of their feet touch a flat surface, they will attempt to walk by placing one foot in front of the other. This reflex disappears at 6 weeks due to an increased ratio of leg weight to strength. It reappears as a voluntary behaviour around 8 months to 1 year old. The Palmer grasp reflex. The Palmer grasp reflex appears at birth and persists until 5 or 6 months of age. It is stimulated when an object is placed into the baby's palm. A normally developing neonate responds by grasping the object. This reflex emerges 11 weeks in utero, and is inhibited 2 to 3 months after birth. A persistent Palmer grasp reflex may cause issues such as swallowing problems and delayed speech. The tonic neck reflex. The tonic neck reflex, also known as asymmetric tonic neck reflex, or fencing posture, is present at 1 month of age and disappears at around 4 months. It occurs when you move the head of a child who is relaxed and lying on his back to the side. The arm on the side where the head is facing reaches straight away from the body with the hand partly open. The arm on the side away from the face is flexed and the fist is clenched tightly. Turning the baby's face in the other direction reverses the position. The tonic neck position is described as the fencer's position because it looks like a fencer's stance. The Babinski reflex. The Babinski reflex occurs after the sole of the foot has been firmly stroked. The big toe then moves upwards or towards the top surface of the foot. The other toes fan out. This reflex is normal in children up to 2 years old. It disappears as the child gets older and may disappear as early as 12 months. The tonic labyrinthine reflex. The tonic labyrinthine reflex is a primitive reflex found in newborn humans. With this reflex, tilting the head back while lying on the back causes the back to stiffen and even arch backwards, the legs to straighten, stiffen and push together, the toes to point, the arms to bend at the elbows and wrists, and the hands to become fisted or the fingers to curl. The presence of this reflex beyond the newborn stage is also referred to as abnormal extension pattern or extensive.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.